So the next talk is by Takeshi Sugawara on three-share threshold implementation of AES S-box without the fresh randomness.
Okay, thank you for the introduction. And the first slide is overview, background, and also timeline of this study. And that is about threshold implementation that there was an explanation in the previous presentation. And this is a great first-order masking scheme, but there was a difficulty in realizing this three-share and uniform threshold implementation for the standardized algorithms, I mean AES and Ketchak, for more than 10 years. At CHEST 2017, Dimon tackled the problem and proposed a very great technique called the changing of the guard and applying it to Ketchak to realize three-share and uniform realization of it. And later, the Wegener and Moradi used this technique to AES and realized four-share and uniform realization of AES S-box. This is also a big achievement because it is the first uniform realization of it, but the number of share was four, and we want to go further. And in this talk, what I did is generalize this changing of the guard and using this generalized technique to make three-share and uniform threshold implementation of AES S-box. Okay, so let us begin with the threshold implementation. And this is, the idea is to implement cryptography while keeping shared representation of intermediate variables. So the share is in this case, I show a three-share representation. So the share is about triplet, and the sum of them represent the original value. And we get a set of mappings that maps share to another share that we call sharing. And this sharing has some important properties to satisfy to be threshold implementation. So correctness means the output share represents the output of the target function. And the non-completeness means each of these sub-functions get only a subset of the input share, which is about security. And another important property is, yes, uniformity. And if we say the share is uniform, that means for each raw value, all the possible shares should appear equally. So this table shows a toy example of three share of one bit value. So this raw value zero has four shared representations, and they have the same probabilities. Then we can say this share is uniform. And this uniformity is necessary for security against statistical attack. We can also say that the sharing is uniform, and that means the sharing preserves the uniformity about shares. That means if the input share is uniform, then we can get guarantee that the output from the sharing is also uniform. But this uniformity is not so easy to satisfy, and there have been no uniform sharing for this standardized algorithm, as I mentioned earlier. And if there is no uniformity, we need to do some compensation. And that is to make operation called remasking in between two shares. And this remasking needs fresh randomness, and that is costly in implementation. Otherwise, if we have uniformity, we can just skip this thing. And that's why we want uniformity. And this is the changing of the guard proposed by Dimon at CHEST 2 years ago. And the idea is to use a neighboring input share for a kind of pseudo remasking. So this is the diagram of changing of the sharing for three parallel mapping S boxes. And the idea is get two portions of the input share, input share, and XOR it with the neighboring output. And this technique is applicable to bijective mapping, and yes, Ketchak S-box is bijective, and so DMEM successfully making three share and uniform sharing of Ketchak S-box. But it is not so easy to apply it to AES S-box. That is because to reduce the number of shares, we need to decompose AES S-box into a series of operations like this one I show. This is can write S-box realized by field operations. And in this kind of decomposition, we almost always have multiplications as shown in the colored boxes. And the multiplication, of course, has two inputs and one output, so it cannot be bijective. And that is the problem. So I try to solve the problem, and the basic idea toward the generalization is since it is difficult to convert the original mapping into uniform sharing, so we first retransform it to another form that has uniform sharing. So that is the idea. And the first trick I used is what I call expansion. And what I did is to transform the target function psi into a bijective mapping using the phase tail network. So this psi is the original function, and this entire structure is the extended mapping. And what I did is just add this extra input y and extra it with the original function output, and also add one extra output here. And this phase tail network is a common structure for block cipher researchers and guarantees bijective property of the resulting mapping. And another good property about this expansion is that this expanded mapping always has uniform sharing. This one is unshared representation, and this one is shared representation. And important thing is this phase tail structure is preserved in a shared representation, meaning that this shared representation is also bijective. And this bijective property is sufficient for the uniformity of the mapping because since this is the bijection, the output is just a permutation of input shares, so it doesn't change the distribution of shares. But yes, with expansion we can get bijective mapping, but we cannot just directly feeding this to the conventional changing of the guard because the resulting function is a little bit different from the original one. We have y added, and what we really want is something, I mean, the one without y. So we need y to be zero, and we should get zero somewhere else. Then I use this second trick I call restriction, and the idea is this unnecessary output, the x that we will not use anymore, to zero by using this null mapping. And this is a kind of symbolic thing that maps anything to zero, so it's essentially just an unconnected wire. But anyway, we convert this unnecessary output to zero, and this zero is fed to the neighboring sharing. Okay? And this restriction, I mean the null mapping, also has a uniform sharing. I think this is a common technique in multi-party computation, and what we do is just drop the first element from the sharing, from the share, and replace it with XP plus XC. And we can easily verify that this share represents zero, right? So we can convert the share into zero inefficiently using this circuit. So this is essentially the proposed method. So what we need is given a target function, target mapping psi, and extend it into bijective mapping using phase tail network, and then put a null function to convert unnecessary one into zero. And let us talk about how we can chain these functions with each other. And let us talk with an easy case where we have the same input and output sizes. And in this case, the connection chaining is very easy, like as shown in this figure. So we have three extended and restricted mapping, and we connect with each other with 50% overlapping. And the resulting map is a parallel application of this psi with some zero in it. And conversion of this chain representation into its shared representation is straightforward. We can just replace them one by one and get the shared representation of this parallel application of the extended and restricted mapping. And this particular connection is important because it shows how this method is a generalization of the changing of the guard. This one on the left is the sharing we discussed in the previous slide, and another one on the right is the daemon's changing of the guard sharing, and actually they are the same. They may look differently, but try moving this left side thing, the up thing into left, and this down thing on the right, and they should look similar, and actually they are equivalent. So the discussion I made in this presentation gives yet another proof to the daemon's changing of the guard with some relaxation. I mean, it also supports non-bijective mapping. Okay, so I also explain how the things going to be in case when the target mapping has different input and output sizes. And this target function is complicated, but the real one we need for AES S-box. So this one has three input and two output. And combining, expanding it to with phase tail network is straightforward. And also applying null function is also straightforward. But the chaining is a little bit different from the previous one because we have different input and output sizes. So we have some extra output zeros that we can use later. The other way around happens when the output is larger. In this case, we need to add some extra zero to the input. So managing this additional input and output is an essential thing when we try to apply this technique to a complicated target function. So this is how I applied the technique to AES box, and this is looks complicated, but yeah, I don't have time to explain this detail. What I did is get a four-stage can-write S-box and expanded it so that every stage becomes uniform. For that purpose, I had to add 6-bit additional input and 6-bit additional output. So the data process is expanded from 8 to 6, and that is the major performance drawback. So this 6-bit thing becomes the register overhead in the state register and also the approximation of initial randomness. So the 6-bit is added for each S-box, and we multiply it by 3 for a 3-share representation, and we have 16 S-boxes. So this to 88 bits is, let's say, overhead of this proposed method. And this is not small, but it's better than conventional four-share representation in terms of circuit performance. So I'm concluding this presentation. So I propose a generalization of the changing of the guard that also support non-bijective target mapping. And using this technique, I could realize the first three-share and uniform threshold implementation of AES SBOX. Thank you very much.
Any questions? I have one.
Hi.
So recently we have papers that optimize the circuit representation of the AES box, right?
Mm-hmm.
So your technique will carry over to another representation of AES box than just the CanWrite representation?
That's a good question. And I think yes. Let's say, but we need to, let's say, for making it three-share sharing, that each stage should have algebraic degree of two. So we need, if we can make that kind of decomposition, we can apply this technique.
Thank you. So if there are no questions, let's thank the speaker again.